Okay, my think tank report for today is about the G7 summit. So the G7 summit is a summit, like the name says, between more or less the 7 richest and most developed countries in the world. So not China, because it isn't that developed. Half the country is still in poverty, and that's 500 million people. These countries are the UK, the USA, Canada, Germany, Italy, Japan, and France, but the EU is also represented there by 2 people, so it's kind of 8, but technically there's only 7 countries. And the G stands for group, so it's technically called the Group of 7, and it was formed in 1975 as the G6 because Canada wasn't in it, and in 1994 Russia joined, so it became G8, but then in 2013 Russia invaded the Crimea, so they were kicked out. And the main point of the G7 is to make sure that the major economic powers are on the same page and coordinate political and economical moves. So they make sure one country isn't not trading, or it's like doing something to slow down the economy, or maybe it has policies that doesn't work for other people, or it wants to share its policies because they are working. So it's basically to generate like a better economy. They work to help poor countries get more developed and make sure that the world is relatively economically stable. So if there's like banks that are too big to fail and stuff, they might like split them up into baby bells, like they almost did with Microsoft. Like in the 90s, I think they almost did that. And the G7 countries represent 46% of the world's GDP, so that's gross domestic product. It wouldn't be a domestic product if it's the world, so gross world product. And 32% of the global purchasing power parity, and it's abbreviated PPP, is how much currency they're worth, how much money their currency is worth, like how many bills they've printed and how much all those bills are worth relative to, I think it's the US dollar, because the US dollar is the universal trading dollar. When you want to trade things, then you pay for it in US dollars. The first one was in Paris. And then they've been all over, and one of them was in Russia, but then they got kicked out before there was another one. The most recent one was in Japan, and they had an emergency one in 2014 because Russia invaded the Crimea, and they wanted to sort out like how that was gonna work. So they all sanctioned Russia for doing that, so they didn't trade as much with them with Russia. And the next one will be in Italy. I think done.